Hi, welcome back to Cooking with Allie. Today we're going to cook a classic meatball. And, you know, there's a lot of meatball recipes out there. And what's important in making a meatball is not always the recipe. It's the method of making the meatball. So that's what we're going to learn here today is the methodology of making this meatball great and not having all the oils out. Now, I've had a lot of meatballs in restaurants, and a lot of them are decent. A lot of them aren't that great. So we're going to make a really great meatball here, and we'll have the recipe on the site later on. So we're going to make sure we have some white bread. We have some Parmesan cheese, some garlic, parsley, basil, some breadcrumbs, a couple eggs. And we have some ground beef and some ground pork here. Now, you can use ground beef instead of pork. It's up to you on the flavor and the richness. It's a lot easier when you go to the store to get ground pork than it is to get ground beef. And the leanness of the ground beef, you can get 15% fat in it, or you can get 20% fat. Depends on how lean it is. You know, most chefs are going to say they want more fat in it, but I mean, how much more fat do you need, especially when you're putting cheese and eggs and everything else? So first of all, what you want to do is you want to cut off the edges of the bread. You're going to have to do this process a lot more. You're probably going to lose a lot more end pieces. I have about 4 slices of bread here. I have about 1.5 pounds of ground beef, and then I have about 1/2 pound of ground pork. Now, what I'm going to do here with the bread is I'm just going to roughly chop it. It's nice and soft, so I'm not too worried about it. Okay. And I'm going to throw it in a bowl, and right away I'm going to soak it with about 1 cup of milk. Okay. Now, again, what I'm looking for to do here is I'm creating a binding agent to help the meatballs bind together. With, you know, a lot of times when you make the meatballs, you're putting breadcrumbs or bread in there or crackers, and when you cook it, they ooze out and have all these pockets in there. So what you're doing here is you're soaking the milk so that it absorbs the bread. Sometimes it takes 5 to 10 minutes. It could actually take 20 depending on the amount of and how hard and thick your bread is. So I'm just going to put it to the side, let it soak up. I typically would make my meatballs earlier, not right when dinner starts. I want to make sure that my my ground beef and my pork are really chilled, so 40 degrees the temperature of the refrigerator, because you want them to be stiff and stable. Okay. Now, I don't typically mix them in a mixer. I use my hands, so I toss that around real quick. I'm going to add about 1/4 cup of breadcrumbs in there. Okay. I'm just going to add a little bit of cracked black pepper. And again, you're not going to need a lot of seasonings in here, you know, when you have cheese and basil and parsley. Okay. And just a little dust of salt in there. I'm not dusting too much in there. Chili flakes, only if you like it spicy. I put a little chili flakes. The recipe doesn't call for chili flakes, but those of you that like spicy meatballs, you can add a little bit of chili flakes in there. You can always use some cayenne pepper. I'm going to crack 2 eggs in here. So it's really easy. Just make this in one big bowl. Okay. Before I start mixing up, I'm going to grab a little bit of parsley. I'm going to take about 2 tablespoons. And then a little bit of basil. 2 tablespoons of that. Leave it loose. A knife here. And I don't have to chop it too fine. Just enough so it just binds it to the meatball, gives us a nice flavor. Okay. Parsley and some fresh basil. Now you're going to taste the freshness when you have those fresh herbs in there versus dry. I mean, you really get the flavor. It really comes out at you. And about 1 cup of Parmesan cheese. Now you're going to see that's a lot of cheese. You're going to see the difference in this meatball when you put that much cheese. And about a teaspoon or 2, depending on how much garlic you like. Just chop up the garlic real fine. Again, you're just binding everything in here all at once. So it's just nice to have all this stuff, and you don't have to sit there dirtying a lot of dishes. And again, as I mentioned, the meatballs have to be cold. So again, if you're taking your time, you get distracted in any which way, and the meat is sitting there on the table a little bit, when you're done making the meatball mixture, just put it back in the refrigerator until it gets nice and cold. It helps form the meatballs better, and it cooks them better when they're really nice and cold. Otherwise, they start making meatball pancakes. Okay. So with this being done, I'm just going to use my hands and lightly toss it. Mix it. Again, over-mixing ground beef is not a good idea. And just kind of fold it in. Okay. Look at that. And squishing it through my fingers. And you can smell that flavor. Okay. It's nicely binded there. I'm going to turn around. Okay. We're going to pretend that this was sitting there for... I'm going to actually smash this up a little bit more. So again, you're creating a binding agent that's typically, in the culinary world, they'll call panada. Usually they'll use eggs in there too, but we already have the eggs in there. So we're going to add our bread here. How nice that is. That's with the milk. And we're going to mix it a little bit more. Okay. Now, if you notice, I'm making a little bit extra, and the recipe is called for almost 2 pounds of mixed protein here. Now, what I like doing is making enough for dinner, and then I like to freeze a little bit so I can pull out when I'm in a rush. I can have some meatballs out of the freezer. I can just pull out and thaw out real quick for dinner. Or if I'm having a cocktail party, I have some meatballs that I can just heat up and, you know, and you don't have to cook them all. You can actually freeze them raw and then pull them out and finish them off, okay? What I do to be safe is we're going to put this in the refrigerator for approximately maybe 20 minutes just to get a nice chill on it. Okay, so we allow the meat to rest inside the fridge so it can get cold again. So what we're going to do is I like using an ice cream scooper. So this way it measures it out equally and we're not left with uneven meatballs. Now you don't have to roll them right away. If you want to, you can roll them as you scoop them out, or you can just scoop them. Make sure you press up against the ice cream scoop and just drop them there and then later on roll them, or you can have someone rolling them for you. Okay, just put them on the sheet pan. I don't need to oil the sheet pan or anything. I'm just trying to scoop them out real quick. See how nice and firm they are? Beautiful meatballs. There. And again, I want them chilled. I want them nice and cold because, and they don't have to be perfect meatballs. I just want them to be able to form better. And again, if you have a meatball that's nice and soft, what's going to happen is when you're trying to cook it, it's just going to go into a flat pancake. And that's what you don't want. You want a nice meatball. Again, I'm making these meatballs bigger because I like big meatballs to eat. I like to cut right into them. If you want to make them smaller with a smaller ice cream scoop, you can. You can find these ice cream scoops online at Amazon or some other local food store that sells restaurant supplies. Yeah, they're only a few dollars and not that expensive. And again, depending on your family size or how many you're cooking for, you could double the recipe. Or again, I would take the meatballs from here and just freeze them, you know, put them in a nice container or Ziploc baggie and freeze them. And again, you can just keep pulling them out as you need them. Again, I like using gloves because I don't like to have food all up in my hand, so you should have gloves at home at all times when you're cooking. It makes it a lot easier and a lot cleaner. Okay, so what we're going to do right now is I'm going to put these in the refrigerator. If you're trying to get them done fast, you can put them in the freezer real quick and cut the time in half. But again, like I mentioned, if you cook your meatballs ahead of time, you're prepping them ahead of time, you could just cook them last minute when you're ready to cook, but you could prep them in the morning and have the meat sitting there and ice chilled so you don't have to keep going back and forth. Okay, these meatballs have been refrigerated. They're back to about 40 degrees, 30 degrees even better. But again, they're nicely firm now. So again, most chefs and restaurants are just going to take the meatballs and toss them in the oven and bake them. If you're at home, again, you're probably going to have the time. And I like to pan sear them and cook them in a frying pan with the sauce and deglaze them and add additional flavor to it, especially if I'm going to put them with the over some penne pasta or rigatoni or some spaghetti or linguine. So I'm going to take a little olive oil, put it in my frying pan, make sure my frying pan is nice and hot. Okay. Make sure. Okay. So we're going to lightly cook these slowly, okay? Just throw them in the frying pan there. And don't overstuff the frying pan. Again, you can always get a larger frying pan. And, okay, just leave them there to sear. I can add the others later on, or throw them in a big frying pan. Now what I'm gonna do to this is gonna be a little more special. I'm gonna actually, I want a little onion to it. So I'm gonna clean up an onion here. I can smell those meatballs already. Now what we're trying to do is brown them, basically sear them so they get some color on them. I don't like to just throw them in the oven and watch them bleed all the oil out of it. I like them to kind of baste themselves, especially with the cheese in there. So what we're going to do is just take a little bit of onion. You don't need that much, okay? And we're going to julienne it. All right. Just going to add some flavor. We're going to add some garlic. Now again, I can chop up my garlic really fine. I don't want to chop it up fine. I want to slice it because I want it to pan fry. Little garlic chips there. And again, this is up to your preference and what you like tasting. I'm going to make sure these things sear really nice. I'm going to have a little bit of wine here. I have a little chicken broth on the side and we have some tomato sauce. Okay. Now they're going to stick slightly to the bottom, so I'm going to slightly remove them. Remember, they're going to stick a little bit wide because they have a little cheese in it. There you go. Aren't those beautiful? There you go. Beautiful, beautiful meatballs here. You can see it's harder to work in a little tiny frying pan. All right. Now once I turn them over, put them over lightly. Finish off there, enough oil in there. I'm gonna throw the garlic so the garlic can start pan frying. You sear all those aromas inside your home or your restaurant. Okay. Turn it up a little bit higher. And then I'm going to add the onions. And this is just going to add additional flavor. You don't have to add onions if you don't like to. And if you don't want that much garlic, you don't have to add the garlic. This is just my preference. Okay? You can hear that searing. Heat it up a little bit more. I'm going to lightly deglaze. Again, deglazing is taking all... See, when I seared those meatballs, you can see the brown beef and the cheese. I'm lining the pan where it sticks onto it. What I'm doing with the wine, you know, the flavor of the grape actually, I'm going to lightly deglaze it. Look at that. Okay. And then I'm going to add a little broth. Okay. And bring that back up to a boil. Now, again, a lot of chefs aren't going to do this. They're not going to take this process. But again, I'm making this for the home process. I'm going to bring this broth up to a little boil here. I don't like heavy sauces in my food. I don't like it to be a pasty sauce, nice and light, so we can cook it lightly. Now I'm going to add a little bit of the tomato sauce and let it bind in there so it kind of slightly braises. Okay, so this whole process is probably going to take probably about 10 minutes. Okay, so let these meatballs cook in the sauce. As you can see, the meatballs have been braising approximately about 10 minutes now. Probably a little bit less if you made them smaller. Now, as you notice, I put chicken broth and wine and then a little bit of tomato marinara. It just reduces down. That's why there's no use in putting a lot of just pure tomato marinara and just let it cook, because you're not baking them in the oven. You can actually take them off the stove and finish them off in the oven if you wanted to. But again, I like braising them on the stove slowly. If you had a lid, you can put a lid on it and you can walk away, go do something and come back. If you don't need a lot of seasoning to it. If you want to add a little spiciness to it, you can add a little more pepper to your sauce. If you wanted to, you can put a little bit of chili flake if you wanted the sauce a little bit on the spicier side and just let that render down, okay? So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna turn it off. The meatball's been nicely cooked and we're gonna stick them right nice into a bowl. Now again, you see that garlic in there and that onion, it's great. You don't have to put the onion and garlic in there. I just like to have a little more flavor. You can put this right over the pasta if you like, or you can just heat up the pasta and put it on a platter real nice and hot, or on a plate, keep it nice and hot, and then have them serve their own meatballs over the plate. So again, you do that on the top and you have this nice sauce. Just make sure you mix around. And again, it's not very heavy. See how nice and beautiful that looks. Oh, there you go. See, it's not so thick and heavy on tomato leaf. Sometimes you get so full, and sometimes it's not even the pasta, it's the sauce, it's too much. Now, I like to use some fresh Romano cheese, and just gonna lightly grate that over the top. There's nothing better than fresh cheese. You know, the dry stuff is, you know, just doesn't have the freshness of the flavor. Add as much cheese as you want on there. A little bit or a lot. But I know tend to like a lot of cheese. And you can just put a little bit of parsley. Now again, there's plenty of parsley and basil inside the meatballs. You really don't have to add much more. But there you go. Okay. House-made meatballs. And I'm telling you, these are probably really delicious and cheesy inside. Oh, look at that. A little hot. Mmm. And they're not thick. They're not heavy. They're just kind of just so light. They melt in your mouth. You can see the texture on them when I put them on the bowl. That they're very fragile because they're not heavy like a meatball stuffed with nothing but breadcrumbs. You know, you have pure flavor in this. Oh, that was so delicious. Okay, thank you.